everyone, welcome to my channel where we talk about informed birth, we talk about breastfeeding, postpartum and a lot of different things around women. Today we're going to talk about preparing our postpartum. Salut tout le monde!
Salut tout le monde!
Salut tout le monde! Hi everybody, welcome to my channel!
Bonjour tout le monde, ici Rachel et bienvenue sur ma chaîne, la vie de Rachel.
Why do I want to talk about this? Because I feel like a lot of people prepare their births. A lot of people prepare their baby stuff, rooms, strollers, and all of those things. But I see that a lot of us don't prepare our postpartum healing journey. Because it is a healing journey, it's a transition journey. It's really a place where we need to acknowledge and honor our bodies as well. And it's easy to forget that, it's easy to neglect ourselves at that stage. So it's good to have a plan to make sure that we do not fall into those harmful ways. Today I'm going to talk about three big themes that we need to prepare for in postpartum, and we can have a plan, and plans are not necessarily what is going to happen 100%, but at least it gives us a guideline. The first thing we need to think about is what is our plan physically? And physically, I mean, you know, for healing and promoting healing. And I think a lot of that also comes from honoring our bodies. And if you want to check out that video that I made on how to honor your body in postpartum, you're going to have the things that I'm going to say right now, which is rest. Rest is very important. Your body just went through an intense and really hard process of birth. You grew a baby inside of you and you had to help it get out of your body. You grew a whole organ that detached and left a big wound in your uterus that needs to heal. Your other organs were squished and everywhere. Now they have to kind of recenter and just take back their place. Your muscles were distended. Your skin was distended. There's so many things that happen to our body, and a lot of times actually, instead of thanking and honoring our bodies, we critique it, and look at it with disgust. We have to be so much more gentler and loving and just acknowledging and just thanking our bodies for the work of having, you know, growing these children inside of us and them coming out as perfect as they are. So that's a perspective that is very important to have, I think. So yes, like I said, rest. There's also wrapping your body to help it support your skin, support your organs just getting back into place. There's also, you know, postpartum baths, vaginal steaming where you're just, you know, cleansing your body. So like I said, I made a video about this, you can check it out. The second thing you need to prepare is your mental space. And I think, like I just said, connecting to your body and acknowledging the work that it's done also helps you in that mental space. But more than that, I think being educated and knowing about postpartum depression and hormones and just like this transition phase that's very stressful on your mind is important as well. If you know about postpartum depression, then you know what to look out for, and I'll make a more specific video on the topic. It's very normal to feel depressed a little bit after birth for a couple of days because you have such a drastic shift of hormones. But then if you're looking into something that is lasting on a long period of time, you're getting more into postpartum depression. So what can you do to make sure that if it happens to you, you can spot it, or the people around you can spot it and help you so that it doesn't become critical? The next thing I want to say is really like the logistics. So what are going to be the logistics? Who's going to take care of the house? Who's going to take care of the other children if you have some? Who is going to take care of the laundry and the food? And having a plan, like, that's why pregnancy to me is 9 months. It's really giving you the time to think of a plan. And I know that especially now it's hard because we live in societies that are very individualistic. Now that we had the coronavirus, people are not even like really able to move around as easily to help others. But we can still plan and find solutions. That's why we have to take ourselves in advance to find those solutions. You can also hire and do postpartum work. I specifically do postpartum work, and we can help you with this. We can help you with your health. We can help you with having a moment to yourself and just resting and food or whatever. So having a plan is important. What I want to say today, let me know in the comments, what was your postpartum experience, and what did you do to make sure that you were prepared? And then let me know in the comments, if you haven't had a kid yet, what is your postpartum plan? So thank you so much for watching, and I hope you have a great day. Make sure you share this video and make sure you like it and you subscribe to my channel for more videos like this. Thank you and have a good one.